Hey guys, today I want to talk about Nightmare Dungeons and what is the most efficient way of doing them. Of course, you can go with the cool, fun way of just doing whatever Nightmare sigils you have and you do them for fun and nothing matters. And that is really cool. In fact, that is what I did for like the first 10 levels that I was doing Nightmare Dungeons. But then I thought, oh brother, I already experienced this system. I want to make it more efficient. And that is how I discovered all these tips that I am going to talk to you. Again, you cannot do this, but if you want to be more efficient in your farming of the dungeons, in terms of this, takes into consideration two things: experience gained and the experience for the glyphs. Because one of the most important things about grinding Nightmare Dungeons, because you can not grind that Nightmare Dungeons, you can go for the normal dungeons or for Hell Tides or for whatever, but one of the best things about spamming Nightmare Dungeons is that you get experience for your glyphs, for your Paragon board, and they provide a great amount of power. Like, a big portion of your power in the late game comes for the glyphs in the Paragon board, so you have to do Nightmare Dungeons because it is the only way to level them up. So the tips that I am going to give to you is how to be more efficient in terms of gaining level experience and gaining experience for your glyphs for the Paragon board, brother. So, the first thing that you have to learn to be efficient in your Nightmare Dungeons is how bonus experience work in Diablo 4. When the mobs have one level above you, they give you like a little bit extra experience. If they are two levels above you, they give you like, I don't know, 15-20% extra experience. But the cap comes when they are three or more levels above you, and this is the max, they give you 25% more experience than they would normally give you. This phrase is really important. When the mob is three levels or more above you, they give you 25% more experience than they would normally give you. That means that if you want to take advantage of this cap, while at the same time making the mob the weakest that it can be, so you can kill it the faster that you can kill it, the mob should be three levels above you. But that doesn't mean that it is not efficient to kill levels that are mobs that are higher than that, because they still give more experience. The 25% doesn't go up, but the experience that the mob gives originally does go up. So there is a little bit of wiggle room in terms of selecting what type of mobs you can kill. But now you will ask me, and this is the tip for Nightmare Dungeons: how do I know what level are the mobs that I am going to fight in a Nightmare Dungeon? For some reason, and I don't know why, the level of the mobs inside a Nightmare Dungeon are the tier of the Nightmare Dungeon plus 54. That is a formula to know what level the mobs are going to be. So for example, if you have a level 10 or a tier 10 Nightmare Dungeon, the mobs inside are going to be level 64. So how do you know to be efficient for your experience bracket? What I do is that I just take my level, I take 50 levels from that, and that is the dungeon tier that I want to do. For example, if I am level 60, I take 50 levels from that, then I am tier 10. You know what that means is that the levels inside are going to be level 64, and then they have 4 levels over me. You can do it with 51, but with 50 it is easier to do the math, whatever, it is just laziness. Plus, you don't have like any disadvantage for having one tier more. So that is what you do. You wanna know what level to do? Just take your level, take 50 away from that level, and that is the Nightmare tier that you wanna do. Why? Because the level of the mobs are the minimum level to make to kill them easier, and they give you the bonus experience. The wiggle room is that you can take this 1, 2, 3 levels higher if you are still killing them faster and everything is fine, you know? So again, if you are level 70, you take level tier 20 Nightmare Dungeons, everything will be fine. You can go 22, 23 if you are still cleaning them faster. And that is all that you need to do in terms of experience. Now, if you wanna go deeper, There are some dungeons that are more efficient than others. Why? Because they are shorter, because they have more mob density, they have more elites, because the objectives are easier to complete. There are a variety of reasons, brother. So if you want to be more efficient, you should aim to complete these dungeons, because they are, again, they are more efficient in terms of XP per hour and XP per hour for the glyphs, brother. I didn't do this math, but some uber nerd on the internet figured out what is the which dungeons are the most efficient ones. So I am going to just give you the list of the most efficient dungeons. I am going to tell you what are my personal favorites, and you can go from there, brother. So the best dungeons in terms of XP and in terms of XP for your glyphs, and in my opinion, the dungeons that you should be aiming to complete are Alderwood, Blind Burrows, Earthen Wound, Gulran Canals, Onyx Hold, Abandoned Mineworks, Crusader's Cathedral, Demon's Wake, Redwing Wilds, Sunken Ruins, Champion's Demise, Cultist Refuge, Mollwood, Renegade's Retreat, and Witch Water. My personal favorites are Mollwood, Alderwood, and Blind Burrows, brother. Those are my favorite to complete. I believe they are fun, they are quick, they are easy, they have cool objectives. So I try to complete those as much as I can, but you can do all of them from this list. What I do is that if a dungeon isn't on this list, I don't do it unless I really like the dungeon, because it is just less efficient to do it. I feel like I am wasting my time, so I just salvage the sigils that are for dungeons that are not on this list, brother. And as you see, there is like a cool variety of dungeons in this in here, so enough to not feel like you are running back to back the same dungeon. Again, just take a screenshot of from the dungeons, and you can just have a list in hand and you know, look over the sigils that you have to know if they are for the cold dungeons or not, brother. And the last thing you should have into consideration when knowing what sigils for Nightmare Dungeons to be efficient is the affixes, brother. I normally don't care about the big affix. You know, the big affix is the dungeon spawning a lightning, is the dungeon following around with the thing that obscures your vision, is the affix the stuff that creates a blood boil that explodes. I don't care about that one. All of them are easily doable, but you have two more down of them that sometimes they are annoying. For example, I always salvage the sigils that have the affix that the mobs that hit you from afar burn your resource. I play a druid, and if a fucking mob burns my spirit, that is annoying as fuck. I don't know how it is for other classes, brother, but a fucking mob that burns your spirit, that is the worst fucking thing that can happen to you. So I always salvage those sigils. So in my opinion, you use salvage the fucking sigil for the mobs that burn your primary resource. But then that also says to you that you should look over the affixes and know if the affix is something that bothers your class. Honestly, the only affix that I salvage is that one, the resource one. But I know there are others that are also annoying. For example, I play a druid, I am almost always unstoppable, so I don't care about the mobs that freeze you. But I know there are classes that don't have a high octane on unstoppable, so if you have one of those classes, you should avoid the freezing mobs. There is another affix that is really annoying for a lot of people. If you're playing a ranked class, the suppression affix. The suppression affix is the purple circle that is around the mobs. And if you hit from afar inside the suppression circle, it just destroys it. You have to go inside the circle to be able to do damage. That is a really annoying affix for a lot of classes. So if you are a ranked class, just go ahead and salvage that. So, in my opinion, salvage the suppression, the burning of resources, and the freezing ones. But I only really salvage the burning of resources. This is more subjective to the class and build that you are playing. But what I am saying in here is, if you want to be efficient, if you want to complete Nightmare Dungeons as fast as you can, gaining as much experience as you can, doing bad affixes for your class and build is bad. So you should check out the affixes and just destroy the seals that don't go well. So in conclusion, what you are going to do is that you are going to look at your consumable stuff and you are going to see your seals. You are going to look at their levels. You already know what levels you are looking for. So the ones that are not on your level, salvage, salvage, salvage. Then you see, oh, what are those dungeons on? Oh, these dungeons are on the list and these dungeons are not on the list of the cool dungeons. The ones that are not on the list, salvage, salvage, salvage. And then you look for the ones that are remaining, you look at the affixes, and if one of them have the burning of the resource affix, salvage. And you do the ones that are left, brother, and you can, with all those resources that are left that you get from the salvaging, you can create new seals and always do the ones that are cool for you, and you'll be efficient in your journey to max level, brother, with the experience and with the glyphs experience, brother. And that is all that I have for you, brother. If you want to be efficient in your nightmare dungeon grinding, brother, do these tips that I have right here. This is what I am doing right now. After I was just doing whatever, I decided I want to be more efficient. I started doing this, and let me tell you, you see the difference in how your bar goes up, brother, and how your glyphs go up. So yes, guys, thanks for being here. Let me know in the comments below if you find this helpful. Have you been doing something like this? Will you do this in the future? You don't care about this and you just do this for fun. Let me know, brother. I love reading comments. Also, brother, help me out, subscribe to the channel, give a like, all of that stuff, bro. Thanks for being here. You guys are fucking awesome. God bless ya. And remember, as the great Bill Hicks said, this is just a ride.